Lindsay, do you see what you have created?
Alexa, volume up, please.
Guys, can we quickly just talk about the vibes in this room right now?
Alexa, play a song.
It's so hot.
Thank you.
Guys, the next time I walk into Drew's room, I'm just not even gonna talk to him.
Just talk to Alexa.
I'm just gonna talk to Alexa.
Hey Alexa, how are you today?
Alexa.
She doesn't want to be my friend.
Claudia asked you a question, be nice.
What's the square root of 4,326.5?
The square root of 4,326.5 is 65.78.
You a smart bitch.
In case any of you guys are curious.
Oh, wait. Drew coming in.
Okay, ready? Maybe I just press harder.
No, it just doesn't like you.
Oh, there we go.
Cool.
What? Magic.
Okay. Hey guys, so what day is it? Thursday. Yes, it is Thursday morning. I just finished getting ready. I'm about to leave to go to my audition and I'm freaking nervous, but I'm so excited. I'm ready. One of the scenes that I have to do, I have like a 3-paragraph crazy bitch monologue and I'm so excited to kill it. I can't stop smiling. Okay, so I just got out of the audition and I feel so freaking good about it. So basically, once we got there, they made us choose one of the scenes to audition with. And part of me was like, okay, the first one, like it's more of a conversation, it's chiller, definitely like the safer route. But the second one, which I was telling you guys about, is like the crazy monologue that's super long. And I think right away my gut was like, Claudia, you know you need to do the monologue. Just go do it. You're gonna do great. And so I did the monologue and there was only like one person in there. And we just like did it right away. And afterwards he was like, whoa, you just got so into that. And I was like, yeah, like, I don't know. I was really nervous about doing the longer one because I didn't realize you guys would make us pick. And he was like, no, like, I'm glad you did that. And so I just feel so good about it. Usually for the most part, they have a very specific like type of girl or type of look that they're looking for. So my goal for today was not to like get the part, but it was just to show them my talent and what I can do. It's just good to, you know, start showing your face and getting people to recognize you and remember you. Sorry, I'm getting texts right now. I feel so happy, so I wanted to capture this because who knows what I'm gonna be doing like years from now, and I'll be able to look back at this and be like, Claude, remember that one time you had like your first like really real audition? Now I'm gonna bless Kanye by the Chainsmokers, because fun fact, that is my go-to song to play after any shoot or before anything that I'm nervous for, because it just makes me feel really happy and pumped up. And yes, I'm gonna go talk about it with my manager. I'm excited. All right, bye. You guys didn't see this angle of the moment that was just captured, but literally when I said that I went yes. And now my leg is, yeah, let's put it back here. Okay, I wasn't kidding. Car literally to my left just gave me the funniest look ever. Like, literally, she's probably still watching me right now, but she just saw me dance with a camera in my hand, and now she's watching me talk to a camera in my hand. Oh my god. All right, she's gone now, but that was so funny. I just got home, I ate a hummus wrap, now we're here. So I know usually the point of vlogs is to show your day, what you're doing, where you're going, who you're with, whatever it may be. But I'm really into this whole idea of like, hey, I have something on my mind and let's sit here and talk about it. I got really great feedback on the vlog that I did where Lexi and I were sitting in the car talking about different things. And I wanna do more of that kind of stuff with you guys, because I feel like it's definitely kind of trickier to have this type of, you know, one-on-one or let's talk about whatever, you know, with how my channel is and things like that. And so I want to do this more often in vlogs because it seems like you guys really enjoy it and it just makes for such greater conversations in the comments. But I was having a thought in a car, and like, this isn't like a revolutionary thing that I like just thought of, but I was just really strongly feeling it in the car, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna wait until I'm home and film it in my room rather than like freaking getting into a car crash on the highway. So I want to quickly talk about happiness, because I've noticed lately that a lot of you guys have been commenting and tweeting saying that watching my vlogs makes you really happy, and you guys will mention how my happiness starts to become contagious to you when you're watching my videos, and that the happiness kind of sends through. And I love getting those tweets and those comments because that is seriously one of the greatest compliments ever. I've always believed that happiness is super contagious. Anytime you see anyone smile, usually you end up smiling back for some odd reason. That happiness comes into you. I believe in the whole universe thing and how everyone has a different energy and a different vibe, and obviously it totally depends on the day and the mood and stuff like that. For those of you who maybe have troubles seeking happiness or finding it or realizing it, I want to give you a quick tip. Because I do this all the time and it seriously makes me so happy out of the most randomest things ever. And it's not like you need to hear any great news or see anything awesome to be happy. You can literally choose to be happy at any second during the day. So that's kind of like the first thing, is happiness literally comes from within. You can choose to be happy every single day if you want to. And I know there's people out there that struggle with depression and stuff, so that's, I understand, is a different case. I've never dealt with that, so I can't relate to it, and so I don't wanna, you know, have that go unnoticed. I don't know, I just don't really know a lot in that field. I'm just kind of speaking for the general, and I really do feel like this could apply to everyone, small or large. But just in general, having control over how you react to certain things can also make you a lot happier overall. So for example, like if you're out in public and you're even just like grabbing a ticket from a valet guy or something, talking to him in a more happier and positive attitude will literally release happy energy out of you and go to him, and then that happy energy is gonna go somewhere else. That didn't really make any sense. What I'm trying to say is whatever you put out into the universe will come back to you. I'm a firm believer in that, and the whole law of attraction, manifestation, all that stuff, I live for it. I believe it so much to a certain extent. Sometimes I see documentaries and they're just like a little bit too crazy and you're like, ah, I don't know about that, but I do really, really strongly believe it and kind of live my life by it. You wanna attract good things into your life, before you can have that, you need to put out that. So whether you're talking to your friends, you're on a phone call, you're talking to a stranger, just genuinely responding to all of those interactions with a happy mindset and a good attitude will literally pass on that good energy, and through the cycle of chains of communications and everything, there are so many people on this earth, eventually it's gonna come back to you. And you, oh my god! Alright guys, so wow, the quality!
Wow, it's so good.
Well, basically, my camera battery just died, but I want to continue this real quick. So we're using the good old Canon camera.
The big one.
Yeah, this is officially a collab now. Okay, so I'm kind of forcing Joe into this, but we're talking about happiness.
Okay.
And in general, just talking about how, what you can do to kind of generally be more happier person. And I was saying how, like, when you're just out getting a drink from Starbucks or whatever.
Just for that, I complimented on her skin because her skin was flawless. I was like, oh my god, I love your skin. Like, what do you use? And she was telling me about some Lush product that she used. And I feel like she was happy because
and then,
of it.
Yeah, bam, you spread that happiness. And she most likely will spread that happiness to
another
a different
customer.
Or another co-barista, whatever, co-worker, exactly. Barista. That kind of trails off to, anytime you have good thoughts about someone, share it.
Yeah.
There is no reason to keep that in if it's that pure and genuine and happy. Like if you see someone that's really pretty, just be like, yo, by the way,
we
like you're
always
stunning.
Do that.
We do that all the time.
Or like you see someone's hair and it's really cool, it's like, yo, I love your hair
yeah.
so much. They like appreciate it.
They do. Or like it doesn't even have to be about like physical looks either. Like just in general, randomly telling your friends like, by the way, you're so funny. Like you are literally one of the funniest human
beings
I know.
Just very
things
important.
Like that.
Yeah. Like your friends, like if you have something nice about them and you like genuinely think it, like why not share that with them? Like remind your friends how much you like them.
I feel like the more you build up the people around you and, you know, help them like
become confident makes you become a more confident person. Mm-hmm. Because I know, like, people always say that, like, the things that you hate about others or that upsets you about others is usually what you hate about yourself.
Yeah.
If you make those changes and stuff and you just, like...
It will help. 100%. Exactly.
This has been a good talk.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Drew just got home, so we're gonna hang out now, but
that's
it for today's...